welcome to Reitz Arena as the undefeated Terriers of Boston University come in to take on the Greyhounds today. It's field trip day here, folks. 500 little ones here to at the arena, and it's rocking with elementary energy. It's going to be a sizzling game today. Thanks for joining us. We're going to head right to the starting lineups for Loyola and Boston University. Sit back and relax. Starting lineups for the Loyola Greyhounds. Talia Dixon. Out of Baltimore, the McDonough School, the 5'10 forward, playing guard. Boy, she's been hot lately, folks. Keep an eye on her as the lights go out here. It's always a great presentation here that the Hounds put on. Stephanie Cars, number 10. Keep an eye on her, folks. Defensive player of the year last year. Leads the Patriot League in steals with 4.4. Listen to that energy of all the kids here from the local Baltimore area schools here to cheer on your Loyola Greyhounds today here on Patriot League Network at Watch Stadium. There's Talia Dixon, number 4, the guard forward, playing really well lately, getting more playing time, i.e. the start here. Number 23, Delaney Connolly, the 5'9 sophomore forward out of Vienna, Virginia, also patrolling the paint. And number 13, Isabella Tarian, also fondly known as Izzy here in Baltimore. She's just getting going here this year, folks. 5'9 sophomore forward out of Marlton, New Jersey. And there's Stephanie Cars, the junior 5'11 guard forward out of Middletown, New Jersey. And then the roadster, BBW, the fifth year player, Bree Betts White, rocking the number 11 for John Wall, her favorite player, at Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. Small in stature, folks, but spirit is large. Our officials today, Keith Miller, Dirk Lurk, and Kara Sedgy will be patrolling the basketball court for you. And for Boston University, here are your starting lineup for them. It is Katie Nelson, the guard. A trio of seniors on this squad leading the way. Nia Thompson, number 3, out of Waldorf, Maryland. I'm sure there are family and friends here for Nia. Peyton Houck, the player of the week in the Patriot League for her exploits the last two games. The 5'9 senior guard out of York, Pennsylvania. Nia Irving, the junior forward, 6'1", out of Fairfield, Maine. Nia is leading this team in points per game, 13.1, our player to watch. And number 21, Lauren Spearman. Downtown Lauren Spearman, 5'7", senior guard, has been heating it up from three-point land, leading the team at 38%. And those are your starting lineups. It's a Patriot League matchup, 2-0. Boston University coming on to take on the 0-2 Greyhounds in desperate need of a victory. Should be a good one here, folks. First year coach patrolling the Terriers. You can see her in the upper left of your screen. Mosley. Spent 9 years as an assistant coach at UConn under Gino Auriemma. Also a Boston University graduate. She has changed the culture here for this team. They are 2-0 and they just came off a huge win at Bucknell. And fans of the Patriot League know that is not an easy place to win. And a first-year coach comes in, changes the culture, and boy, she has got this BU team feeling confident. Meanwhile, on the other sideline, 14th-year head coach Joe Logan just getting this team together, the synergy, the energy rolling. We're two games into the Patriot League, long way to go, and the tip goes to Katie Nelson of BU. as they get set here. Thanks for joining us, folks. Everybody up in Boston and those of you in Baltimore and all the friends and family of the players on the court, welcome. I'm Jamie Watson, happy to be here today calling play-by-play action for you. There's Nia Irving, she likes to go left. Little miscommunication which can happen on the road. And oh, by the way, the 500 kids here, they're all cheering for Loyola. They're gonna make it a little challenging for the Terriers. Greyhounds setting up on their first offensive possession here. Bree Betts-White looking for Stephanie Carrs. Ball will remain with the Hounds. Coach Mosley coming out with a man-to-man. There's Dixon, the jumper. Just off the back rim. Always the first few minutes of a game. Teams feeling each other out. Bree Betts-White, you know, outside the perimeter, folks. The last couple years they've been calling that. You can't hand check. They're oddly trying to speed up the game. Once the player almost gets a steal there and it causes her to put her hands on her hip. It's supposed to speed up the play because once the players get it, they don't hand check and then play flows. But these first couple years, they're gonna call every hand check outside that perimeter. There's Katie Nelson working off the screen. Strong defense. And there's one of your league leaders, 70 Carrs, cleaning the glass, as we like to say. Carrs with 10 rebounds per game. I think it's the fourth in the Patriot League in the entire league. Little 1-4 set here on offense. Delaney Connolly looking for White. White stuck. And there's some great defense and a shot clock expiration there for the Hounds. Good look. Good look by Katie Nelson. Unable to get the conversion there on the layup. The lefty, Katie Nelson driving left. I'm sure Loyola's gonna make her go right the entire game. Here comes Spearman, who's been hot. It's a three-pointer missed. Scramble for the ball. Loyola comes up with it. There's another missed layup. Missing the bunnies on both ends, folks. Oh, there was a nice pass in the paint there and a travel on Nia Thompson. Good help defense by Delaney Connolly. Just talking to Megan, the SID for BU. And she was talking about the change of culture here for Boston University and Lauren Spearman, number 21 here, as we look at her playing the guard position. Didn't play the first 3 years here. And now, with that's a charge, a clear charge. Good call by the official. Bree Betts-White getting that forearm out, folks. Can't do this. Cannot extend that arm into the belly of the defender. That's gonna be a charge every time. Alexis Gray. Downtown sharpshooter for the Hounds, number 20, checking into the game. 5'6 junior guard out of Clarksburg, Maryland. Alexis leading the team from the free throw line. There's Peyton Houck, number 4, jump stop. beautiful use of the glass. Find the corner of that rectangle, kids, and that ball's gonna go down most likely. Peyton Houck, player of the week I mentioned in the Patriot League for her two-game performance, 32 points tallied. A senior guard for the Terriers. Here comes Dixon working Nia Thompson. And for those of you who haven't been following the Hounds like we have, Talia Dixon has really come into her own in the last three or four games. Just a freshman out of McDonough, the McDonough school here, the hometown player. And there's Peyton picking up an early foul on Stephanie Carrs, who this year starting to gel, trying to come into her own as Bree Betts White comes back this year. Stephanie Carrs was relied on heavily last year, and they're just trying to figure out how to get back into the flow of their offense from last year while, like every team, bringing in the new players. There's Carrs down low. Beautiful look by Gray. Well-designed offensive set by the Hounds. Both squads play terrific defense. Coach Joe Logan's squad's known for their pesky defense. They take care of the rock, and here, Spearman out. Nice box out by Delaney Conley. It's a good steal there by Spearman to get her hand in there. Izzy Tarian mouthing to her teammates, my bad, my bad. So just like every season is new, that both squads have had a, you know, non-conference tilt. The Terriers come in 6-6 and the Hounds come in 1-12. And I think Coach Logan will tell you that that was, you know, a bit lofty. But, you know, when you play up competition, you know, you tend to raise your own play and you learn. And that's what this is about, learning. Katie Nelson from downtown, and that is what Katie does best. You're gonna have to get out on her and guard that. Katie Nelson coming in 27% from three land. They're gonna call a block, and it's quite possible that Nia Irving was in the restraining arc. And the restraining arc will tell us where her feet were, but it is a foul on, yeah, just a little bit inside, feet not set. And we're going to take a media timeout. Timeout on the floor means we're going to take a quick timeout. Make sure you stay with us. We'll be back in 2 quick minutes. Look at those beautiful faces. It's field trip day here, folks. We've got 500 young girls here with their teachers enjoying. Look at the smiles. Loyola women's basketball here at Reitz Arena. On the line is Talia Dixon, the freshman who's really come on strong these last few games. Talia, solid, rock solid from the line. 71% on the year so far. And there's Dixon with the steal and a beautiful dish to Delaney Conley, who puts up the left hand. Wow, strong play by Peyton Howell. You can see why she racked up 32 points in the last two games. The senior guard leading the way here, her very first player of the week. And a tough shot, the reverse layup by Tarian. Love the effort, but tough shot, and there you see Carrs, 4.4 steals. You can see why she leads league and led the league last year. It's just a gift. She has the gift of thievery in the most possible positive way we can call that a gift. The reverse layup are shots that are, you know, reminds me of the back heel pass in soccer. Not my favorite because they're not accurate, and it's Loyola needs to focus on the fundamentals. The easy bunnies aren't going down. Make those first before you start doing the reverse layups. There's Cars doing what she does best. There's Izzy. Once Izzy gets rolling, she's a streaky shooter. Watch for her. And they've been waiting for her to do that. She's coming off a little bit of an injury the last couple games. So Izzy's somebody who can heat up quickly for the Hounds. And there's a reverse layup that goes in. Way to prove me wrong, Naya. There's leading scorer Naya Irving, who will be patrolling the paint most of the game and leads the Terriers in scoring. Just grazed the rim for Izzy. Comes Peyton Houck. Another steal. Fast break. Beautiful passing. And one for Dixon. I missed the foul, but Dixon will head to the line, and thank goodness for replay, because we're going to be able to see the and one. Great passing. Textbook bounce passing. Talia up and in. Little fist pump by Coach Logan there. Exactly what this team has been needing is just a little run of confidence. They lost their last game up at Army, leading after three quarters, and just was not able to finish. There's Spearman downtown in the corner. And that'll stay here, and hopefully Naya's okay. Little ankle roll. Oh, she's all right. Naya Thompson. Did not call that off Alexis Gray. Called that off Naya Thompson. The 5'11 senior forward out of Waldorf, Maryland. Not too far from Reitz Arena. Unlucky. Nice pickoff pass. Stillen, straight up. Man-to-man. Nice job shutting off. Good help defense by Delaney Conley. Peyton asking for help. Three on the shot clock. And that's the foul you don't want to give up. Talia knows it. Upset with herself. You play solid defense, folks, for 27 seconds. You don't want to give up that foul and give him a new shot clock. Live and learn that she's just a freshman. Here comes Peyton. Beautiful rotation. Two rolls and a coffee. Doesn't go down. Loyola looking to cut into this 10-9 lead. Actually, Loyola, a one-point lead. My bad, 10-9. Sparked by their terrific defense, as usual here. Conley will take that shot. There's Cars again. And Talia, the floater. Doesn't go. Conley in the paint. Doesn't go. And Izzy to Conley. And Katie with the stop and go. Gives it up for Spearman. Gonna settle things down here as Spearman. Lauren Spearman, the 5'7 senior guard out of Los Angeles, California. Peyton getting that to roll. That's how you make those bunnies, and BU takes the lead, and we're already 30 seconds to go in this first quarter. It's flown by. Fasten your seatbelt, folks. It's all the elementary energy in the building with the 500 kids from the Baltimore schools. My aunt was one of them, taught at Pimlico, teaching kids how to read. That's what it's all about. Academics first, students second. One. She had to launch that, run out of time, and that will end it here, folks. With a score of BU 11, Loyola 10, and a fast-paced back-and-forth first quarter. Yep, we're going to take a timeout. We'll be right back. Stay tuned, folks. Welcome back in, folks. You're looking live at Reitz Arena. It's field trip day here. The energy is just incredible. 500 kids from the Baltimore area schools. Hey, it's always fun, field trip. Everybody remembers field trips, right? Well, what a sizzling first quarter. 11 points for Boston, 10. Here comes Carter's driving left for Loyola. Nice fake. Got to use that glass. That little rectangle will guide you on the backboard. The story so far, you know, at least for Loyola, the last several games has been field goal percentage. They've gotten 14 good looks, only made four baskets, and BU 5 of 12. So there's a nice drive. Great little no-look pass by Katie Nelson, point guard. So I was speaking to the assistant coach, Noah Sag, but let's take a look at the replay real quick. Look at this little left eye no-look pass by Nelson to Thompson. It's a good foul there, folks. You want to make them earn it, as they say, from the charity stripe. And Nia Thompson does just that, canning her first free throw. 64% from the line for Nia. Out of Waldorf, Maryland. Nia's a senior, and most everybody from the BU side has been talking about the change in culture, thanks to first-year coach Marissa Mosley, who spent 9 years patrolling the sidelines with Gina Auriemma. Here's Dixon, will launch from three land. Really good look, and again, as we were talking, just the ball doesn't drop, and that's what we were talking to Noah Sag about from Loyola. It just hasn't gone in. We're getting the looks we want, so looking to improve field goal percentage, they are. There's Carrs, always getting a hand on the ball. You just cannot take your eye off of her. And that's tough to stop. How do you stop that first step? You got to back off to Leah Dixon. That's how you stop it. Let Peyton Hawk make a three-point on you, which she hasn't yet, before you give up the easy deuce to the basket. Give her a little room. She won't blow by you if you give her a step. Can hear the countdown from the kids, and Carr's runner doesn't go. Wow, and that gets the Loyola bench up off their feet. Nice block. Coach Cole, Marissa Mosley, where's the foul? Looking for a foul there. None given. Letting them play, they are. Here comes Carr's. Look at the move. Got a little body there. Not the arm or the ball. Anyway, no foul given. Terriers by five. Oh, terrific pass by Spearman. 2 points for Katie Nelson. To the sophomore guard, Katie Nelson. Spearman, the veteran senior, the one I was telling you about. Lauren spent the first 3 years on the bench, and everybody's like, why? And now, under first-year coach, she is just taking off with confidence, and she's killing it. And Courtney Vinoy checks into the game and is able to contest that rebound, and Loyola will keep possession of the ball. Gray will reset. If you recall last year, Bree Betts-White out all last year. Gray got tremendous minutes learning how to be the point guard, and you see that here. Next man up, always in the injury situation. Call it good as Coach Harbaugh and the Ravens made it a mantra this year, and it's one of mine as well. No matter what happens, call it good, make it good. You can. And there's a foul in the paint. Lauren Spearman picks up her first, and Hannah Niles checks into the game. Hannah Niles, number 32, the junior guard, 5'9", out of Glen Echo, Maryland. And unable to corral that one in. Yeah, there was a travel, but the travel was because there was a foul. And Alexis Gray called on the foul of Spearman. Yeah. The challenge is you got to get in front of that, and Spearman's quick and heads to the line. I think that's Lauren's first miss of the year from the line. Averaging 10.9, folks. Lauren Spearman didn't play the first 3 years, now averaging 11 points. What's that tell you? Tells me that Coach Marissa Mosley has changed the culture officially here at BU, and her kids, the women, are playing with tremendous confidence, and they're having fun. And that is what it's all about, right? The big picture, having fun. Tarian, nice pick. Give Izzy Tarian that kind of time, and she will make you pay, folks. And she does. Hounds looking to get back in the second quarter. Good help defense there. Looks like a little bit of a matchup zone. Spearman drops it in the corner. You can see Lauren playing with some of that confidence. Spearman with 4 points. A little bit of a matchup zone here. Coach Mosley throwing out a different look. There's a nice three by Hannah Niles. And there's a timeout on the floor as the Hounds cut into this lead. It's 21-15, down by six. 5 minutes to go. Let's take a quick look at the replay before we head out. Here's Terry, and nice dish out to Hannah Niles with a beautiful rotation. And down it goes, folks. You stay right there. We'll be right back, folks. And welcome back in, folks. You're looking at field trip day here in Baltimore, Maryland, as the Patriot League contest, always a challenge. We're in our third game of Patriot League play where the stakes are always raised. Conference play is the second season, and Boston University comes in undefeated, and the Hounds yet to win, and Katie Nelson drops a 12-footer. The lefty Nelson, silky smooth for the Terriers. Terriers have been on a bit of a road trip, 911 miles, if you want to know. They went from Boston out to Lewisburg to Bucknell, where they took down the Mighty Bison. And they spent, here comes Izzy downtown, off the back rim, and spent some time in Georgetown. They went to the Lincoln Memorial and spent some time there visiting our nation's capital before heading over here. And they will head back home for two games at home. And there's a foul on Cars. Gotta be careful. Stephanie's first for the day, but she has been known to have some foul trouble, and gonna get called for the reach there. And that's just good defense by Hannah Niles, challenging Peyton Houck, the Patriot League Player of the Week for the Terriers, her first one ever. Congratulations to her, the senior guard out of York, Pennsylvania, just about 50 miles north of here. And there's Dixon, seemingly with the free runner. And here comes Gray, wide open three. And yep, Stephanie's gonna get called for over the back there. That'll be her quick second foul, and Coach Joe Logan knows Stephanie's propensity. She's just, you know, Stephanie Carrs just goes all out all the time, which is exactly what you want. Except for sometimes she gets in foul trouble. So Coach Logan has to manage it, and he does it well. Isabella Tarian comes in for Cars. Spearman. She coaxed that one down with the squad there. Come on. Little pressure. Three-quarter court from the Terriers. Seeing that Bree Betts White is off the floor, typically handles the rock with such grace. So does Alexis Gray. She learned last year, she did. A natural two guard is Gray. And again, you can see the Hounds are getting the shots. 6 for 20 prior to those couple of shots. Just not going down for them. And meanwhile, the Terriers are 8 for 16, shooting 50%. So it's all about getting that good shot, obviously. Tarian working. That's a beautiful end one by Izzy. Katie Nelson has a little question for the official about that, but that's what the Hounds need to do, drive and dribble, drive and dish, and that's what's working for the Hounds right now. And Izzy does not extend that forehand, forearm, so she doesn't get called for the charge, and that's what you need to do. It's a good three-point play for the Hounds. Closing in on halftime here, Hounds looking to narrow the deficit. Man-to-man, and there's another pick, and Katie Nelson makes them pay. I'd like to see Loyola do that for Alexis Gray out on the perimeter. She's that good, Alexis is, from Treyland. Terriers in a zone here. The Hounds trying to pick it apart. And Gray, that is a patent runner of hers. She's quite good at it. Didn't go down there, but she loves that shot, and it's usually a high percentage shot for her. New shot clock. Again, Bunny's not going down. Dixon getting to the rack pretty easily. Katie Nelson. Beautiful save by Naya, unfortunately to the wrong team. And Dixon getting a little, so my high school coach used to say, stop swinging from the rafters. You need an element of control. Sometimes we tend to go too fast in speed, especially when you get close to the rim, folks. That's when you got to dial up your concentration. Slow it down in your brain. Here comes a pick, and they leave it open again, fortunately. And there's a nice follow by Nia Thompson. Just beating the Hounds in the paint and on the boards. And that's why the Terriers are leading. Up by 12, minutes ago. And that's a terrific steal by Katie Nelson. And Nelson, the natural lefty, gets fouled by Dixon. I think that was a pretty good call. Most times when you come from behind folks like this, let's take a look. Trailing. I mean, it has to be nearly perfect. And it looks like she clipped the top of her head, a little bit of arm as well. Nelson from the line, a little bit like money in the bank, as they say, 86%. Katie Nelson. Nelson, homegrown up there from Falmouth, Massachusetts. My old stomping grounds. Love Boston, love New England. Hosting a big football game up there this weekend. I'm sure everybody knows Tommy Rader and the Pats. Just spirit of excellence up there. Anyway, looking for that here as Izzy Therrien drives right and will get the call. And that's Katie Nelson picking up her quick second foul. Yeah, it's important because Katie Nelson has been leading this team with 11 points, and now she's forced to go to the bench. The Hounds look to capitalize on her departure. And in comes number 30, Vanessa Edgehill, the junior guard out of Franklin, Mass. The 5'8 guard getting some minutes here for Coach Marissa Mosley, first year coach. Oh, just off to an undefeated start for the Terriers. What a hire for them. Spent 9 years with, 9 years with Gino Auriemma, and basically she just said he's a great resource of basketball skill. Yep, Bree Betzweig gonna get called for the block there.
Personal foul, right now.
Right here, you gotta get to the ball. You gotta move to the ball. I think that's the problem here. She's just standing still. And Spearman detects the pass. Nice steal. But when you talk about fundamentals, guards, players, you must move towards the basketball, and the official's given Bree Betzweig an explanation of that. But Marissa talks about working for Gino, and basically she's like, every day in the gym, it's back to fundamentals. You know, it's not rocket science. We just, you know, Gino just hammers fundamentals, and he, obviously he gets quality talent, but that's what these Hounds need to get back to, just basic fundamentals. In other words, making the layups, making the free throws. They're free. Figure out a way to make them. And that's just great defense, Peyton Howe. Loyola just not getting the ball where they need to, mostly because of the outstanding defense. Again, when you talk about fundamentals, you can see what Coach Mosley has been doing is just really drilling them in those fundamentals. Learn to master those before you start, you know, doing reverse layups and things like that. Team control foul, thank you. It's always nice when the officials come over and chat with me. Speaking of, Keith Miller, Dirk Lurk, and Kara Seji on the floor. Thank you to our officials who do the very best job that they can do. Under five, and a shot by Spearman. Terrific look. What a year Lauren Spearman's having, and that'll end our first half of play here at Reitz Arena. Exactly how you want to end it. We're gonna take a quick break, come back with halftime highlights and stats, and bring you a hopefully sizzling second half from the Hounds. Stay tuned, we'll be right back. And welcome back in, Hoops fans. You're looking live at Reitz Arena here at Loyola University in Baltimore, Maryland. It's nice to see 500 kids here today from the Baltimore area. It's field trip day, and man, they are having fun. Dance party was outstanding. It just reminds me that I can't dance, but boy, how I can in my own mind. I'm Jamie Watson. Thanks so much for being here. We're so glad to have you. 11:30 a.m. tip. I think some of the Loyola players are still waking up as the Terriers have a 35-18 lead, but there's still plenty of basketball to play here. Stats tell the story, as they always do. Boston University, a 10-0 run over the last 3 minutes. I'm so impressed with Marissa Mosley, folks, the first-year coach for the Boston University Terriers. She's got her players changing the culture, playing with confidence.
forehead saturated blood. He changed the jersey with 0 penalties. Double zero now.
I love how serious officials get when they talk about blood on the jersey. He just informed me that. That is what happened. Our officials, Keith Miller, Dirk Clark, Kara said you're doing a great job today. Thank you, everybody, for joining us. Welcome in fans from Boston, from Baltimore, from all over the land, tuning in to watch these players play their hearts out. Thank you. It's Leah Dixon. There you see double zeros, and that's what the official was telling me. She had saturated blood, and they removed that jersey. Now she wears double zero. Was formerly wearing number 4. Talia Dixon. We'll be watching her fly to the hoop. She's a really good driver of the basketball. And here's Katie Nelson. Great guard play from them in this first half. We're in the second half now. And I tell you, got to go over top that screen if you're Bree Betts-White. You cannot give Katie Nelson that shot. The 5'8 guard from Falmouth, Massachusetts, shooting 27% from three, but today I believe she's 3 for 5, well above that 27%. Got to get out. And here's Conley from the corner. And the runner by Dixon finally drops. Talia Dixon wearing double zero. And Delaney Conley with a little shove underneath the basket. Nia Irving does a nice job. She knows the box, the post area. She is their post player. She plays it well. And if you get that entry pass into Irving, she will make you pay. Conley picks up the foul there, takes a seat, and here comes Hannah Niles into the game for the Hounds, wearing number 32. Steph Carrs, those swift hands of hers, the queen of thievery in the Patriot League. Gotta be careful, 2 fouls on Carrs. Here comes Katie Nelson. There's a nice box out by Bree Betts-White. Peyton Houck getting her hand in the passing lane. And another hand in the passing lane, both ways. Stephanie Carrs, Peyton Houck, that's how you do it. And Peyton Houck will pick up that block. That'll be her second personal foul. And you'll see the replay here. Talia Dixon, folks, just really having a breakout season. Or I should say, coming into her own in these last couple of games. The freshman didn't start at the beginning of the year, and now she's really getting the rock. And Stephanie Carrs does. That is a travel. Trying to back down into the post is Carrs. That time well done by Bree Betts-White, getting over top the screen. Loyola now fighting over those screens. And there goes another one. And that is exactly how BU has been killing the Greyhounds. Spearman and Nelson, guard play. Loyola saying, we can do that too. Doesn't drop for Hannah Niles. You start to press the 20-point lead. You start to press a little bit from three land. It hurts more, though, when you're one and done. You can see this Terrier team's going to be right there at the end, quality side for first-year coach Maria Mosley. Coach Logan taking a timeout real quick here. He's seen enough. He's going to make some changes here. Wouldn't be surprised. We're going to take a media timeout. We'll talk about that when we get back. You're watching Loyola Basketball on the Patriot League Network. Stay tuned. Welcome back in, folks. That's Coach Joe Logan in his 14th year here. He's got a serious look on his face. His kids never quit on him. going to make some changes here. I imagine we'll see some pressure defense, a little bit more pressure defense to try to claw back into this 22-point lead by the Terriers. Wow, and a buzzer beater by Izzy Terrien. Beautiful. They're gonna call that a three, but I think they're gonna look and to discuss whether she got that off in time. I'm gonna say yes. Now, I'm pretty sure she was behind the line, although my view is obstructed a little bit, whether they're looking at whether her foot's on the line or whether she got it done in time. But again, we have such a crack video production crew led by Stephanie Ann. Those feet, and yes, indeedy, Izzy Terrien knows how to stay behind the arc. The question is, plenty of time. This should be an easy call. That's good, folks. Well done letting us see that before. It's field trip day. Look at those beautiful faces. Future basketball players. I got a chance to listen to Coach Logan as I was walking in a couple hours before the game, and he was addressing these students, talking to them about what a good teammate is. And it's one reason why I love Coach Logan. I mean, the important things in life are how to be a good teammate. And, by the way, Loyola fifth nationally in their GPA. It's all about the classroom, folks. These players are going to go on to be important young professionals. So make sure you take care of what's happening in the classroom. And Loyola does it like nobody in the United States. Congratulations to them. Let's see how they can get back into this game. Wow, that's just tough. Nia Irving, you can see why she is so good in the paint. Just stole that one away. Get two cracks at it on each possession. Boy, the Terriers will love that. Oh, terrific pass. And Cars lays it in. Dixon wearing the double zeros. Blood on her shirt. If you're just joining us and you're a fan of Talia Dixon, look for her as double zero. And that's a nice tie-up. Stephanie Cars got more ball than body on that one. And the possession arrow goes to Loyola. Don't see too many people playing tougher defense than Stephanie Cars. By the way, Defensive Player of the Year last year in the Patriot League for good reason, led the league in steals. And Terrien from three, splashdown as Brady Seabolt would call it. And slowly but surely chipping away at this league, Coach Mosley gonna take a timeout, and you know what that means. I think we're gonna step aside. And welcome back in, folks. All smiles here today, free t-shirts. It's so great. Remember field trip day? I know everybody does at home watching. It's always great to get out of the classroom and out here to, you know, see some quality basketball, and these women on the basketball court are role models, and they are terrific role models, I might add. Great students, great athletes. And hello, Stephanie Cars. I feared for my life for 1 second there. One of my nicknames for her is Ford Truck, because I'm strong like bull. Yeah. Anyway, thank you, Lord, for sparing my life. Stephanie Cars, but all out hustle all the time, as usual. And there goes Katie Nelson. Beautiful defense. That's what we're used to seeing here for the Loyola Greyhounds. Katie Nelson thwarted briefly. Nelson having a game-leading game for the Terriers, 14 points. Hounds have to stop Nelson and Spearman. But then, oh, guess what? There's Halk and Irving. And there's Isabella Terrien in the paint. Izzy is such a special player. Her skill set includes 3 points in the paint, as you just saw there, on the box, on the post, on the elbow. She's sort of a Larry Bird-ish to me. And if you don't know, her dad is Chris Therrien, the outstanding NHL hockey player. There's Nelson from downtown, cooling off a little bit. And the outlet pass given to Loyola, although it looked like it was off Hannah Niles. Stephanie Carr's just the soccer throw-in, length of the court pass. And here comes Spearman. Got to keep an eye on her, folks. She has been red hot behind the arc. And that's Edgehill taking a seat. There's Bree Betts-White finally getting a foul, and Izzy Therrien urging on her Hounds to get back into this game. Still plenty of time. There's Dixon from the corner. Wow, it is just so fun to watch Stephanie Carr swipe the glass. She does it like nobody else. One of the best in the Patriot League, fourth, I believe, at 10.4 rebounds. Enjoy it, folks. Here comes Niles from downtown. In and out. Feels like this all season long a little bit as the Hounds get started here, as Irving starts to manufacture points in the paint, and one. Nia Irving. She's so good in that paint area. You can see, anchors that pivot foot, and down and under she goes. Nia Irving leading this team with points. Hounds have done a nice job in keeping her quiet with just 8 points today. She leads the team with 13. But the Terriers have really been getting it done outside, shooting their guard play. As you can see in this front court, Spearman, 21, and Nelson, number two, have been red hot. And Stephanie Carr's creating a little bit of action underneath. Irving picks up a foul as Nia Irving tries to bounce Stephanie out of the paint. Hounds to inbound. It's a rare day when Bree Betts-White is held scoreless. And there's Stephanie Carr's. She does, one of her gifts is that little turnaround glass shot. She just has an innate ability to make that one. Kara Sedgie's gonna call that foul on Carr's. And, that'll be her third foul, so I'm betting Coach Logan. Here you can see is a double team here. Nice help defense. I mean, slightly ticky-tack, but, you know, again, they're calling that perimeter stuff, so got to know it. Now that's a good steal. Unable to pick it up with the Hound, so it goes out of bounds, but Stephanie Carr, look at those hands. They flash like lightning. Nia Thompson on the drive, and that's a terrific step. Hannah Niles with the pack. But again, well coached, you want to make that foul so you don't give up the easy two. Nia Thompson, 64% from the free throw line, so make her earn it. You can see Loyola has picked up the defensive intensity to try to get back in this one, cutting it to 15, down from 22. Delaney Conley back in the game as Hannah Niles takes a seat on the bench. Terrific block by Nia Thompson. That's good defense by, who was that over there that looked like, Spearman. And there's Dixon on going through, and again, not going straight back up with it was Conley, but rather kicking it out. There's so many missed baskets from 3 feet for the Hounds that they will just need to correct that by slowing down the speed of play. How do you do that? You just have to slow your brain down when you get that close. Dixon from downtown, and that is good. Talia Dixon showing off her downtown range there. Dixon typically wears four, wearing double zeros. Dixon with 4 points in this game, getting much more playing time. You're seeing sort of the growth and maturation of, oh boy, what a terrific pass by Peyton Howe. And a great cut. Basic fundamentals, spread them out. And Thompson with a really good cut to the rim. And Irving trying to pick up the charge, but Talia Dixon able to scoot, slide. And Irving picks up her third foul. So you've got Hauk and Irving with three fouls each, although Irving says two on the scoreboard, so maybe it's just her second. No, it's three each. Somehow get those players on the bench. Could give the Hounds an opportunity, a window to get back in this game. Dixon from the line. That doesn't help to miss the freebies. She's shooting 71% from the line. Dixon averaging 7 points a game for a freshman. As I mentioned, she has been coming on of late, and it's been fun to watch. The Baltimore native, the McDonough High School graduate, cans that second free throw. Man-to-man for the Greyhounds. Betts White getting over top that screen. Well done. Got to cut off that 3-point. And a nice job by Delaney Conley. Her defense has improved immensely over this past year. She's been an important part of this Greyhound squad. Conley, 43% from 3-point range. That is good. Tarion doing a nice job of knocking that ball out off of Spearman. 6 seconds on the shot clock, but I'm sure Coach Logan has a play set for this. Looks like the box. Oh, terrific move by Izzy Tarion. Throws it up. Good awareness of the clock by Tarion, but just better defense by the Terriers. That's a patented move by Irving. She loves going to her left. Got to make her go right. She can go right as well, but tape I watched on Irving, boy, she is solid in the post. Beautiful job by Stephanie Cars. I'm telling you, watching her work in the paint is Bernini-esque. It is like sculpting in there by her. She just so artful. Watch this, how Irving just cannot get a hold on her. As soon as she sees it go up, the fundamentals of boxing out, Cars has, and all Irving can do is back it up with the butt. Coach Mosley is coaching up Irving right now on the sidelines. In comes number 10. That's Ashley Sieper, the 6'2 freshman forward from Tampa, Florida. And Hannah Niles will wait to check in for Cars. Stephanie Cars dropping that free throw, and Niles will check in. Carr's getting a big smile on her face when she makes two free throws. She's so excited. She's been challenged with the free throws lately, but coming on strong, never quitting. There's a double dribble by Peyton Hauk. terrific job by the officials today, I think. Keith Miller, Dirk Lurk, and Kara Sedgy. Not an easy job. Kids watching at home, do not argue with the officials. Let them do their job, you do yours. Hounds working around as we round out this third quarter. Hannah from the corner, finally it drops. And that's a beautiful job as we end this third quarter. And there's Dixon disrupting the passing lane. As we end this third quarter, nice comeback by the Hounds. 52-41 as we end the third quarter and we go into the all important fourth quarter. It's gonna get a look here. Hannah Niles three-pointer. The lefty knocks it down. We're gonna come back with the fourth quarter for you, so stay tuned. Listen to that energy. Imploring the fans to get louder and the referee getting in on it. You gotta love it. He gave the ball to one of the fans who just inbounded it to the ref. It's field trip day here, folks, at Loyola. You've got a great Patriot League contest here. Katie Nelson in front of the booth. Spearman 21 gives it up to Thompson. The guard play has been outstanding. Houck, Nelson, Spearman. Nelson with the ball. And there's another three. And money. I think she's averaging three threes to lead the Patriot League, I believe. Yes, it does. Spearman, I'm sure Coach Logan is aware. Got to shut her down. That is her. We apologize for any technical difficulties that you guys are having at home. You're looking live at the fourth quarter here. Bree Betts White, what a shot. Unfortunately, the shot clock violation sometimes produces desperation heaves, which that was one of them. This Terrier defense has been all out awesome, and so has their field goal percentage was just dropped off here, 53%. I mean, they're just doing what we talked about, the fundamentals, folks. Basketball really comes down to execution of the fundamentals. And again, straight up man-to-man here for the Hounds. Got to get out on Spearman. And there's a nice play. And Dixon, that's a nice block by Houck. I tell you, Dixon, she is graceful as a gazelle the way she floats to the rim. Really pleasure to watch her and bright future here for Loyola. Talia Dixon wearing the double zeros today. It's 55-41 right now with the Terriers leading, folks, with 8:39 to go. And there's Hannah Niles. The lefty lays that in beautifully. It's been a score of runs when you look at the box score. A 24-8 second quarter for the Terriers really got them out in front. And then the Hounds topped them 23-17 in the third. And now here we are in the fourth quarter with the Hounds picking up the defensive pressure. Good hand in the passing lane by Hannah Niles. 12-point game here, folks. 55-43, 7:51 to go in the fourth. Will is going to need some stops here. And Spearman. Oh, boy. Great crossover. But just enough to get her off her mark. Spearman, a rare miss. And Spearman will pick up that ticky-tack foul on the perimeter. No hand checks. You'll see the play here. Right there, just slowing down Bree Betts-White, who is lightning quick. We like to call her the Roadster, the BMW, Bree Betts-White. The fifth-year guard, and that's a nice move by Cars. She just took down two pins there in the bowling lane of Stephanie Cars. Dodge Ram that time. She is amazing. All right. Down to 10 points, folks. 55-45. And there's actually Spear. Oh, that's an unkind rim for Katie Nelson, who has been the beneficiary. Ashley Sieper, forgive me, number 10 for the Terriers. The freshman 6'2 forward out of Tampa, Florida, was in the paint there. And she now takes a seat on the bench. All right, it's as close as we've been in a while, folks. 10 points, plenty of time. Hounds need to execute here, folks. Field goal percentage has been an issue for Loyola. And it looks like a 2-3 zone. Coach Mosley changing it up. Coach Marissa Mosley out of nice play. Beautiful. Conley to Cars for the deuce. And those are the bunnies that need to drop. Execution. Man to man still. Can't leave Spearman open, but just a rare miss. Fortunate to get that. Look at that. It's just pure sheer hustle by Peyton Howe. Been really impressed with their hustle. Marissa Mosley, 9-year assistant at UConn under Gino Auriemma. She just said, look, it's fundamentals. That's what we did. And sure enough, this Terrier team is taking in all that she has to offer from her 9 years at UConn. Good offside rebound on the three. Well taught. Izzy forcing her way in beautifully. Double team, Terrier with the two. 55-49 and a timeout for Coach Mosley as Loyola storms back into this game. And we're gonna head out real quick. Don't go anywhere, we'll be right back, folks. It's a barn burner here. You're looking live at Loyola taking on the Boston University Terriers. It's 55-49 with 5 minutes to go. We now have a ball game, folks. It's been a game of runs. Terriers have been out in front by 22, but no longer. The pressure mounts in the fourth quarter. Let's keep an eye on how the Hounds are going to defend the Terriers. And that's a beautiful start for Loyola as Nia Thompson unable to penetrate that defense and travels with the indecision. Loyola coming down can cut in this to this lead to bring it to 55-51. Closest they've been in a long time. Stephanie Carrs wants the basketball. Bodies are crashing and flying all over the place. Spearman brings it up to the Terriers, and Nelson settles it. Coach Mosley calling for the motion offense. Backdoor cut by Peyton. I tell you, Loyola has done two straight games coming back from getting back into games. Irving, a rare miss under the hoop. Could have something to do with Stephanie Carrs creating a disruption. Thumbs down offense for Loyola. Another opportunity to cut into this lead. And Nia Thompson's gonna be called for over the back there. Starting to get a little nervy. You can feel the tension in this building. 500 kids, it's field trip day. They're excited to see this finish. Hope you are too. And there's a turnover by the Hounds. Coach Mosley gonna use some clock here wisely. 55-49, Terrier lead. 4 minutes to go. Nice crossover by Nelson. Unable to connect. And Spearman will take it. And there's Cars. She's wiping the glass. She took that like Secretariat took the Belmont. She does not quit. She is 9 lengths ahead on rebounding today of everyone. 14 boards for Stephanie Cars. What a pleasure to watch. Cleaning the glass. Leah Dixon wear the double zeros today. 55-49, another shot by Tarian. An unkind rim for Izzy. Will has had several opportunities to cut into this lead. 3.5 to go. Still, 55-49. Just listen to the kids. They're telling the story. Defense. And there's another walk. Well called by Nia Thompson. As my broadcast partner would say, D. D for defense. And Loyola is known for their pesky defense. They have shut out the Terriers in this fourth quarter, shut them down. Coach Joe Logan wants to talk about it. 55-49, 3 to go. Very much still in this game. We're going to keep it here, right here on the floor. Another quality Patriot League contest. Terriers come in undefeated, folks, 2-0. They beat Army West Point and Bucknell at Bucknell. A signature win for these seniors. They talked about that, the Terriers did. The change in culture with Coach Mosley, and of course, beating Bucknell at Bucknell is something Loyola, I think, was the first one to do it in 3 years last year. So, upcoming schedule, real quick, at Holy Cross and at American, the Hounds will hit the road, and maybe the road is what they need, and the Terriers will be at home, I believe, for the next two contests, as they have been on the road already. Here we go. Again, Cars with another rebound underneath the basket, her 15th of the game. Izzy Tarian trying to back it down. And Betts White. Now that's three Betts White, which she does bet. The lead is down to four, 55-51, 2.5 to go. Here at Reitz Arena, fans, kids on the edge of their seats. Izzy with the task of guarding Spearman. Coach Logan putting a bigger player on Spearman, trying to slow her down. But can they slow Peyton Hawk? Beautiful defense by Dixon. Did you see how she backed off there? Make Peyton pull that up. Hit that 18-footer. Peyton wants to drive. We all do. We all want to get closer to the basket. Huge possession here for the Hounds. Conley in the game. Remember, shooting 48% from three. Izzy from downtown. And Conley goes up for that board and gets fouled. Delaney Conley on the foul, and she'll go to the free throw line, I believe. There's Izzy launching from three. Back rim. Conley going up to get it. Delaney Conley, 5'9", going up to about 6'4" there to pull that one down. Conley, a 59% free throw shooter. The junior sophomore guard. Forward out of Vienna, Virginia. Not too far away at all. Nothing but net there for Delaney Conley. The lead is three, folks. 1:38 to go. Hounds down by three, 55-52, Terriers lead. Solid, yet again, nothing but net. The kids are going wild here. as they can see the scoreboard and do the math. It's Katie Nelson, Peyton Houck. How tight is this defense? Oh, and there's a great steal. And a foul call. It's a nice job on the call by the official calling that. It actually slowed down this Loyola defense. I mean, the attack, which I think they need a little bit. Izzy Tarian to the line. Let's take a look at what Izzy's shooting from the line. It's 71%. But Izzy Tarian, one of those clutch players. She is, you know, the proverbial, the one you want in the foxhole with you. She can handle the pressure as Loyola cuts the lead to one, 55-54 with 1:20 to go. This will be the first tie since, I think, 0-0 to start the game. And like I said, Izzy cans it. 55 all, folks. Let's sit back and watch as the Terriers try to put in two in this very tense, tight fourth quarter. What a steal by Dixon. Great play, and Tarian, what a play by Conley. And the Hounds lead. Pandemonium here at Loyola. Coach Mosley will take a timeout. I was wondering if she was gonna pull the trigger there, and she does. Are you kidding me? 57-55 lead. Unbelievable, the Hounds have been working towards this all year. Watch this awesome defense. Double team by Dixon. And Bree Betts White, the roadster, picks it up and sees Tarian, but the rebound here by Conley. That is the kind of hustle that this team we're used to seeing, and Loyola leads 57-55 with 54.7 ticks on the clock. What a thriller here on Charles Street at Reitz Arena, home of the Loyola Greyhounds. Kids are up, they're out of their seats, they're ready to bust loose. There was a dance party at halftime. What are the chances they storm the court? How fun would that be? All right, teachers, let the kids loose. Are we getting, you got a shot of that? Look at that. I mean, they are just so excited, as they should be. What a performance, this Greyhound team. By the way, Loyola just lost a really close one at Army in their last game in the fourth quarter. So they have been working towards this. If they are able to pull this off, Coach Logan will have nothing but high praise, I'm sure. Remember, Loyola comes into this game 1-12. But that's because their non-conference schedule was just outrageously challenging, which, listen, I was a head coach. I did that to my soccer team. You do have to be careful with that, though. Here we go, 55 seconds to go. Let's see what Coach Mosley has drawn up for her Terriers. Spearman from deep, in and out. But a rebound, and I think they're gonna call the push. I thought he was gonna go correct the call. Bree Betts White, and that's Ashley Sieper with a huge rebound for the Terriers. New shot clock. Sieper. And that's a good foul by Stephanie Cars as Nia Thompson. 64% from the line. We're gonna take a look at this. Nia likes to go left. Cars gives her the lane, and then correctly fouls her. Thompson, cool as a cucumber. Excuse me, Edgehill, Vanessa Edgehill, the junior guard out of Franklin Mass Inn. And that is a foul call. The official was blocked by me for a second there. And there will be a foul call. I believe Kara Seggi underneath has the call. I think. They're discussing this. Thank you for the replay. And coach, before the foul call here, you can see the official coming in to call the foul. But I don't believe that they're going to call the foul, that they're going to give Coach Logan the timeout instead, which could come into play because she would have been shooting free throws and now will not be. Loyola will inbound the ball at half court. Remember the rule, 60 seconds and under in the fourth quarter, the ball would be placed at half court. Probably why Coach Logan wanted that timeout. Wasn't expecting a foul to be called, which negates the free throws. But now, Loyola will get the ball at half court. Expect a quick foul, I believe, from the Terriers, unless it's a one-point game. Maybe Coach Mosley says, she'll probably play straight-up defense and try not to foul. Of course, Loyola's up by one. Woo! The announcer is even thrilled. Okay, so 32.7, let's reset. Fourth quarter, full 30 seconds on the shot clock, so that only leaves 2.7 to go. Coach Logan, I assume, will milk that clock with that one-point lead. At some point, Coach Mosley will call for a foul. She'll probably signal when she wants that foul, unless she's going to take a chance with 2.7, which will be left on clock. I say she calls for a foul at some point. It could be early to avoid this pressure. The truth is, folks, I don't know what's going to happen. That's the exciting part. What will Coach Logan draw up? We'll find out in a second, and we'll also hopefully get a chance to talk to him at the end of the game. What did you call for in that last timeout? As a former coach, of course, that's what I want to know. All right, you're looking at a 1-4 setup. Loyola players will break left and right from this angle. Get the ball in to Bree Betts White, one of their best free throw shooters on the team. It's Wise playing straight up. And now Coach Mosley calls for the foul. Katie Nelson gives it. This is why they get paid the big bucks, folks, the coaches. What a chess match going on right now. You gotta love it. Bree Betts White, let's take a look at her numbers. 77%, folks, from the free throw line. Fifth year player, veteran. Exactly who you want on the line in this situation. Nothing but net. 58-56, Loyola leads. Will they press on a made basket? I don't think so. All Loyola players are back. Will Coach Mosley surely call a timeout on a made basket? Oh, and Brett White missed it. That timeout's still called. It's okay. Loyola leads by two. They would have loved the three-point lead. Now, the Terriers will get the ball at half court. And this is huge, folks. And the reason the Rules Committee did this was to make it more exciting. And boy, is it. You don't have to bring the ball up the length of the floor where most likely there will be a full court press. Now you get it at half court. Plenty of time. 23.9, shot clock off. Score, 58, Loyola, 56. Their first lead in most of the game. It's been really quite the thriller here on field trip day. Kids are out of their seats, many of them are. It's a nice place to express the energy that they have inside, which we all know they have a ton of it. Stephanie Carrs imploring her team off camera to no fouls, do not foul, which is the edict handed down by Coach Joe Logan. Let's see what Coach Mosley has drawn up out of the timeout. I would expect Loyola's not going to foul. We know that. Let's watch what they run here. Who are they going to go to? It's got to be Houck or Spearman. Backdoor cut. Going to make her beat you. Help defense. That is a foul call on the drive. And you'll get to see the replay here. Pretty much a foul, shooting two, obviously, on the shot. Katie Nelson, Hannah Niles runs out at her. Good foul. If you get beat, you gotta make her earn it. Unfortunately, Katie Nelson, 86% from the free throw line. 7.6 seconds, and this to tie the game. Izzy Tarian, I believe, on the foul call. Beautiful. It's not a shooting foul, so that's why coach wanted the foul. Now 0.4 seconds. Folks, it looks like we are going to overtime. Let's sit back and watch. And no foul call there. And we are going to overtime. My goodness. What a fourth quarter comeback by the Hounds. The second half was tremendous. We're tied at 58. Let's set up the overtime, shall we? I believe we're staying here to do just that. Thanks. And actually, we're going to go out. When we come back, we'll talk about the overtime rules. Stay with us, folks. We'll be right back. It is overtime time. Absolutely. What a thriller it's been here. There will be 5 minutes on the clock, folks. Overtime rules. One timeout for each coach, I believe. Yes, any timeouts remaining they can use. And a media timeout will be in effect. Woo! I'm excited. Hope you are too. 58 all, 5 minutes to go, and the tip. Nia Thompson wins that tip, corralled by KD Nelson. Peyton Houck, that's what she likes to do. We talked about playing off her a little bit or give her some help defense. Beautiful drive to the basket, dribble drive by Peyton. Patriot League Player of the Week. Dixon pulls it out. 7 seconds. Terrific defense there by the Terriers. Terriers up by two thanks to Peyton Houck's first basket in overtime. 60-58, 4:06 to go. Welcome in, folks. It's been a thriller here. I'm Jamie Watson. Happy to be here. Enjoy this finish. Ball off Loyola, and that's Ashley Sieper, who's had a tremendous impact in this latter part of the fourth period and quarter in overtime. There's Sieper, number 10. And Peyton from downtown. And that's why you make her shoot that. And the freshman throws it away again. A freshman mistake there by Talia Dixon. Great defense by Cars, putting her off. Here comes Bree Betts White, likes to run. They're gonna reset. Plenty of time, attempt to tie this game. 60-58, Terriers lead. Just under three to go. And Terrian drops it. Izzy Tarian down the lane for two. We're tied at 60, folks, 2:38 to go. Spearman from downtown, and Izzy Tarian. Spearman having trouble with the bigger player. And there's Thompson with the foul. And that will be her fifth, ladies and gentlemen. Nia Thompson will foul out of the game with 8 points. And also out of the game already is Nia Irving. They're two bigs out of the game with five fouls. Favors Loyola. Here's your replay. And Hannah Niles gets hacked by Nia Thompson. Vanessa Edgehill in. Niles to the line. Hannah Niles only 50% from the line. Let's see if she can can these. Just off to the left from the lefty. And unable to make either. The pressure is so intense. Understandable. Got to make those, got to finish, got to execute here. There's Edgehill with the motion offense. Edgehill with the step back. Here comes Dixon. And Dixon on the runner. Puts him in the lead, Talia Dixon. Loyola leads 62-60, 1:45 to go. We mentioned her impact, playing great of late. Almost a turnover. No shot. Dixon on the swipe. Katie Nelson just making life difficult for Bree Betts White. Obviously, she's getting a screen. Nelson to the line. 86% free throws. 3 for 4 so far in this game. Oh, and Nelson, a rare miss. Nelson brings him within one, 62-61. We're in overtime here, folks. Minute and 30 to go. Who can execute in overtime when the pressure is the highest? This is why we watch sports, right here, this moment. Izzy did not want to hit that, take that three. It was there. Official timeout. I believe he just signaled shot clock issue. Both teams will head back to their respective coaches. Woo! It is, forgive me for sighing on the air. It's been incredibly tense here in this final, this overtime period here for Loyola with a 1 point lead. 1 minute to go. 4 seconds on the shot clock now, and you can see Bree Betts White here, and you can get a look at the shot clock. Peyton Houck, nice job. So the Hounds will have 4 seconds, I believe, as the officials, as you can see, are checking to make sure we have the right numbers.
Okay, we had the inadvertent reset of the shot clock at 4 seconds. 4 seconds came off the game clock. So that means it's a shot clock violation, red ball.
Fantastic explanation. Keith Miller coming over, informing us. You all heard it, I don't need to repeat it. New shot clock, 101 to go. Each team will get a possession here. Peyton Houck with the two. BU up one. Tarian with the ball. What a steal by Nelson from behind. Often called, but not called there. Got to think a foul is coming with the 1 point lead. And a timeout by Coach Logan. Oh, he's laughing. He wasn't quite sure he called one there, but 14.3 seconds. Woo, for the win, folks. Loyola knocks down a deuce. They can win it. Shot clock off, 14.3. Terriers may elect to foul. They may put them on the line. When you look at overall free throw percentage for the Hounds, only 64% as a team from the free throw line. What do you do as a head coach? Do you call for a foul here? I don't think so. I think they play straight up. They got a 1 point lead to the Terriers. 63-62. Here we go, folks. 14 seconds. Can Loyola walk off with the win here? And Terrian misses the bunny, and Talc brings it the other way. And there is a foul. Unfortunate miss by Izzy. Great play call, wide open. Sometimes, folks, the nerves gets the best of us, and she just hit that a little hard off of the backboard. I believe there's just a little bit of time left on the clock. They're gonna look at it. All things are possible, anything can happen, even if they can just get a half a second on the play clock here. We're gonna take a look at the replay to see what the officials are looking at. You can see in the upper corner of the game clock, 1.3, and Talia Dixon comes over, 0.8, boy, and maybe the arm goes up on, it depends on when the official makes the call. It goes back to execution. We've been talking about it all game long. So it looks like Peyton Houck will go to the line. 0.6 seconds is on the clock. With a 1 point lead, doesn't leave obviously a whole lot of time. And Peyton gives them a 2 point lead. 74% from the line is Peyton, continuing her excellent play. And she misses that one on purpose. And unable to get his shot off. And that'll do it, folks. Boston University pulls out a overtime thriller here in Loyola, 64-62. In a thriller, all heads should be held high here. What a game. Thanks for joining us. As the kids file out, they were treated to a tremendous game. All heart and fight out of this Loyola squad. Boston University wins this one. See you next time, folks.